The promised realignment of confidential and intelligence funds of civilian agencies has yet to be written in the approved spending plan at the lower house. That decision was reached amid fierce criticisms of the Office of the Vice President's Confidential Fund and calls to boost security in the West Philippine Sea.
The House of Representatives will realign the confidential and intelligence funds of several civilian agencies to augment the budgets of intelligence and security forces tasked to address escalating threats in the West Philippine Sea. House Appropriations Committee Chairman Elizalde Co said on Thursday these include the Office of the Vice President and Department of Education. The allocated CIF funds of the OVP and DepEd total 650 million pesos under the 2024 National Expenditure Program. Six party leaders at the lower chamber earlier committed to funnel more funds to agencies responsible for protecting the country's territory and interests, such as the National Intelligence Coordinating Agency, National Security Council, Philippine Coast Guard, and the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri is also backing this course of action. Zubiri adds, all agencies will be under review. Senator Risa Hontiveros, who has been pushing for the reallocation of these funds, lauds the Senate leadership for walking the talk and setting the national priorities straight. The proposed budget for the Department of National Defense and its attached agencies is 229.9 billion pesos. This includes the 50 billion peso budget for the AFP's modernization program, which Defense Secretary Gilbert Chiodoro says is too small.
Nagpapa-rehorizon po tayo ng ating kakailanganin. Tulad po ng MRF, kung bibili lang po tayo ng 12, what's the use para sa akin po, no? Dahil
MRF, sir?
Yung multi-role fighters.
Ah, multi-role fighters.
Kung 12 lang po yan, it does not make a difference. Yung ibang mga bansa po, kung bumili 60, 70.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri has committed to increase the DND's budget and has asked the defense chief to line up all their needs in a closed-door meeting for immediate consideration.
We're going to support, through the efforts of the Senate, an increase in their budget, especially in the defense spending. We are going to allot a large chunk of additional funding for the AFP and the DND.
The DND's proposed budget is now up for plenary debate.
Also on Wednesday, the Office of the Vice President finally faced the scrutiny of lawmakers over its controversial budget. The Office of the Vice President, Sara Duterte, insists it broke no laws and its confidential funds were properly used for various projects. Despite this, the OVP failed to clarify how exactly did it spend the budget.
We emphasize that the OVP's actions are in alignment with the law and has always been in conformity and synergy with the Constitution and co-equal branches in government.
Halimbawa, kung sa OVP, informer ang binayaran, 1,000 mahigit in cash na mga informers ang binayaran, ganon.
I cannot comment on that, Mr. Speaker, Your Honor.
Dahil
the report has already been submitted. Yes, the Office of the Vice President has complied with the report submission in January 17, 2023, and in April 13, 2023, and in July 13 of 2023.
The office also clarifies its 125 million peso confidential fund last year and how it was spent in 19 days, contrary to the 11-day report of the Audit Commission. And for 2024, the OVP is seeking 500 million pesos in confidential funds.
I may also emphasize that prior to the release of this fund, plans were already laid down by the Office of the Vice President. The actual implementation was delayed because the office awaited for the release of the SARO.
Although nakuha ninyo, nakuha ng Office of the Vice President, yung cash starting December 13. So ibig sabihin, nag-aabono na ang Office of the Vice President ng pera para sa confidential fund way before December 13 o yung na-obligate. So ibig sabihin nun, kung kung August man yan.
That is inaccurate. Plans were laid as early as August, but the actual implementation was only after the release of the SARO in December 13, 2023.
The House of Representatives approves on third and final reading the 5.7 trillion peso proposed 2024 national budget without any changes. This leaves the promised realignment of surveillance funds to a small group of House leaders. Now the vote, 296 in favor, while all three members of the Makabayan Bloc voted against the measure. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. earlier certified the bill as urgent, allowing lawmakers to approve the bill on second and third readings on the same day.
I should emphasize the extensive deliberations and negotiations we undertook to pass the 2024 national budget in a timely manner. We are confident that every centavo reflects the overarching targets to usher economic transformation towards inclusivity and sustainability, and is in line with the administration's medium-term fiscal framework, the 8-point socioeconomic agenda, and the Philippine Development Plan of 2023 to 2028. Pursuing the constitutional requirement of transparency, the House of Representatives has to shepherd the national expenditure program, no matter the rigors and challenges along the way. These include the difficult discussions on the confidential and intelligent funds, which the House successfully steered toward a healthy and vibrant exchange.
For House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro, the approved spending plan won't address the pressing needs of Filipino people.
Nasayang lang ang pagkakataong ito sa pagpasa ng pambansang budget para sa 2024 na halos walang pagbabago na pinanukala ng Administrasyong Marcos at walang substansyal na kaibahan sa mga budget ng mga nakaraang taon. Pinapasangan natin ngayong gabi nang walang tayong hawak na kopya na tila pinapipirmahan sa atin ng isang higit sa 5.7 trillion peso check habang nakapiring ang ating mga mata.
Government spending plan for 2024 is 9.5% higher compared to this year's 5.3 trillion peso budget. As Philippine Defense Chief Ibo Chedoro hits back at China's threat that Manila should not cause trouble in the West Philippine Sea. China's warning came a day after the removal of its floating barriers in Scarborough Shoal, which was meant to block Filipino fishermen.
A provocation na ba yun sa kanila? Na, ano ba ang provocation? Yung paglalagay ng barrier o ang pagtatanggal ng illegal na illegal na harang? Hindi naman tayo nag-i-steer ng trouble, hindi naman tayo ang kumukupkup eh.
Former Associate Justice Antonio Carpio says China could be sued for depriving fishermen who rely on the shoal for their livelihood.
The ruling of the tribunal stated that the entire Scarborough Shoal is a common fishing ground. China cannot unilaterally prevent other fishermen from the Philippines or Vietnam from entering the lagoon. Definitely, we can bring an action before an UNCLOS tribunal to recover damages for the destruction of the coral reefs. Let us say we will be awarded, let's say, for example, $1 billion. No. So how do we collect that amount, because China will not pay? So, well, we owe China for the Kaliwa Dam, for the Chico Dam, so we will just offset it because we become creditor and debtor of each other.
The Philippine government is set to release an enhanced national strategy aimed to address the maritime dispute. The 2016 Hague ruling has already invalidated Beijing's sweeping claims in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department is asking Canada to explain why it recently denied entry to former Philippine National Police Chief Rodolfo Azurin Jr. Now, foreign affairs officials confirmed to House lawmakers Azurin was on a personal trip when he was intercepted by Canadian immigration officials. The DFA says Canada's government has expressed regrets over what it calls a misunderstanding and miscommunication. Azurin had accused Police Deputy Chief Rodel Sermonia of sending misleading information to Canada's immigration authorities. Azurin also alleged Sermonia had wrongly informed the media that he was deported from Canada. Sermonia denies Azurin's allegations.
Former Chief PNP Azurin may have been fed false stories again to drag my name on the unverified reports of his alleged deportation. There is no reason for me to do what I am being accused of. Magbista po kami. Bilasko po siya. Kasiraan niya ay kasiraan ng for the questioning was which made retired PNP General Rodolfo Azurin Jr. decide to just return to the country as he stated and not deported.
Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Rhea Torres. Good morning, Rhea. What do you have for us?
Good morning to everyone. As of the moment, we are still monitoring a low-pressure area within our Philippine area of responsibility. And as of 3 a.m., it was estimated at 800 kilometers east of extreme northern Luzon. Although, as of the moment, the said low-pressure area has still no direct effect on any parts of the country. However, its trough or extension is bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Visayas, Zamboanga Peninsula, northern Mindanao, Caraga, and Davao region. Meanwhile, generally, our fair weather conditions may be expected over large portions of Metro Manila as well as large portions of our country, although there are still chances of isolated rain showers and thunderstorms by the afternoon or the evening. We are also currently monitoring a low-pressure area outside our Philippine area of responsibility, and as of the moment, we are not ruling out the possibility that it may develop into a tropical cyclone in the next few days. So citizens are still advised to continue monitoring for updates regarding said low-pressure area. Meanwhile, for the weather this coming weekend, large portions of our country will experience generally fair weather conditions over large portions of our country, although there are still chances of scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over parts of Palawan as well as the western section of Visayas, as well as the central section of Visayas area this coming weekend. And we currently have no gale warning raised over the seaboards of our country. We are expecting slight to moderate coastal waters over our seas. And that is the latest here from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
All right. Thank you, Rhea.